Hello all, today we are going to do the real-time clock adjustments in the Siemens Simatic Manager. So I'm going to set up a configuration, go to File, New, and create a new project, RTC, real-time clock, and hit OK. Then I'm going to insert a new station, which is Simatic 300 station. In the Simatic station, I'm going to set up the hardware first. In the hardware configuration, I'm going to add the Simatic 300 station. First, go for the rack and put the rail first. Then go for the power supply, PS300. I'm using a 5 amps power supply. Then I'm going to set up a CPU, CPU 300. I'm using the CPU 3172 PN bar DP, the third version, V3.1. And then let's set up the communication first by hitting new. We are just doing the simulation, so we don't actually need the proper communication right here. And go for compile, save and compile the whole setup. And after compiling, I'm going to close the whole hardware configuration window. Then we go to the CPU that we have configured previously and go for the S7 program, blocks, and OB1, which is the organization block 1, and changing the language into ladder. Then hit OK. Then here comes our ladder language, our programming window. For setting up the real-time clock, I have to go to the libraries. Go to the library. Inside the library, you can see the standard library. Inside the standard library, I'm going to do the system function blocks or IEC function blocks. I'm first going to the system function blocks. And in the system function blocks, we have to go for the real-time clock adjustments, SFC0, the read clock function, SFC1, system function call 1, which is the real-time clock adjustment. We have to read the clock value. For setting it that, we have to adjust one more thing. We have to add up a temporary variable, which click on the temp and scroll down. You have to add a temporary variable. I'm just typing as T. T is our temporary variable, and the data type will be time, date and time. Here you can see the date and time, and I have to select date and time as the temporary variable, and I have to give the CDT. In the CDT, you have to give the temporary variable T. Here you can see the T. So, and the return value will be a memory word. So NW0, that will be my return value. And I have to add one more network. For adding up some more function blocks, which will be right here. I'm closing the system function blocks and going to the IEC function blocks. In the IEC function blocks, you can see FC6 date, FC7 day, and TOD, which is the time. So date, I'm going to place here the function FC6, function global 6, date. Next to that, that will be day. Very next to that, that will be time. So all the functions has been placed, and everything, every input for these three blocks will be the T, that temporary variable that I have created first, T. And the return value will be MW2. That I am getting the date in the MW2. And for here, same here, T, and this will be MW4. So MW0, 2, 4, and here again T, I am using MD10. I am using a memory double word for storing the time. So I am just going to save this. And we have just saved the whole configuration and go to the Simatic Manager. And I'm selecting the whole collected function blocks and system data and hit the download button. And before downloading, you have to set up the simulation first. So our simulation has been turned on, and have to select all and download. Now everything has been downloaded successfully, and then we can minimize this. Then I'm going to download from here the OB1 and hit yes, and going to establish the connection and go for the monitoring mode and setting up with the runtime. Here you can see during the runtime, here I'm getting the time value here. Here I'm getting the time value. So the input is T, and here you can get the date. Yes, here it's in another format, and the day and the time. So we can monitor all this stuff on the value table or the monitoring table. I'm taking from here. Here I can use the table, right click and insert new object. That will be a variable table, VAT, and hit OK and double tap, and I can add up some things. It will be MW2 will be the date, MW2, and next thing MW4 and MD10. These are the three things I'm getting: MW2, 4, and 10. The 2 will be the date, so I'm changing it to the date format, and MW4 will be the day, and that will be normal, and that will be shown as 2, that I will explain later. And here I'm getting the time, so I'm changing it to time and starting the simulation. Here you can see the time is 9 hours 38 minutes 45 seconds and a couple of milliseconds, the same time here, and the date is 2021 3 15. It is in the YYY MM and DD format, and here we are getting the 2 as a value for the day. For getting what is 2, for knowing what is 2, we have to go to the help of the FC7 function call, hit the F1 key. We can see FC7 DT day, the function block. The 2 represents today's Monday. That's it. So up to 1 to 7 we are getting, 7 is Sunday, 2 is Monday, and we are getting the time and date also in the value table. So to adjust the date and time, we are going to the Simatic Manager and right click and PLC and set time of the day. And you have to set the PC or PG time, and the module time you have to apply. That's it. So we can control the date and time of the PLC also from these three blocks. And if you want to see the clock pulses, we can go to the value tables and open that value table and add up M12.0, M12.1, M12.2, like bits. These kinds of bits are the clock pulses we are getting for time. This is that it's guys, couple of bits will be clock pulses, M12.3 also. We are getting the clock pulses for the date and time saving. And hope you enjoy. Thank you.